So if you look at a map of Australia, then there's something kind of interesting about it as far as our discussion goes here. You see all the usual areas here, Sydney here on the east coast, Perth on the west coast, and Melbourne and Adelaide and Darwin. Of course, it's very close to Indonesia and all that sort of thing. Anyway, but if you look very carefully, the Tropic of Capricorn, right about at minus 23 degrees or 23.5 degrees south, goes right through the continent of Australia. Right here, just cuts through it all the way like that. And we saw this on the map back here as well. Here's Australia once again here, and we see that southernmost limit sort of cuts Australia off right through there. So what does that mean for us? Well, it means, of course, as we said, that the sun's rays are never going to be down here. The direct rays from the sun will never be down here. Of course, it's sunny here, but never direct rays from the sun the way I've been drawing here. And all the sun's rays always sort of hit this line and sort of north, as you know, up to the Tropic of Cancer, which cuts quite far north up through South America. So this part of the world here is where the sun's rays can be. But anyway, what's the story here? Well, I visited Perth once, and I was down there, and I was certainly aware of the Tropic of Capricorn and interested in these sort of things. So of course, there's a highway you can sort of get, and you can drive all the way up here, Shark Bay. You can go pet dolphins in the water and go up to Carnarvon there, and sort of you can keep driving and just sort of wonder what would happen when you sort of get up here. It was a very long drive, maybe something like 6 hours. Australia is very big. Anyway, so what happened is we were driving at some point, this sign popped up, and it says Tropic of Capricorn. It's got a bunch of graffiti on it. Now I know what you're thinking. Maybe I just pulled the sign right off the internet. So I went to Wikipedia, and of course that is the sign right there. So did I really go or didn't I? Well, here's a different looking sign. It's very clean now. It looks like different weather, different day. So indeed, I was there. We did drive there to the Tropic of Capricorn. So there I am standing there. It's just a great day. And I pulled the GPS out of the car that we were using back then. Indeed, you can see this right here is the pole that sign is on. And you can see I am at about 23 degrees and something south. So the GPS does correspond with where that sign is right there. And you always have to do the obligatory jump, and there's nothing down there. There was a German family on the other side of the street doing about the same thing, but there I am jumping at again 23.5 degrees south. That's where I was. And so in this region right here, I think this was to the north, like the highway that way, that was to the north, and that was to the south right there. So again, in this region right here where this dirt is, the sun's direct rays never hit. The sun is never directly over any of these points here, but it's certainly in this area here it is. There's a sign on the other side, so you can sort of really see that indeed there is sort of an imaginary line. There's nothing down there, but there's some imaginary line you can sort of think of existing right there as representing the 23.5 degrees south. And there was the sun up there, but wasn't on any particular day like the solstice or anything like that. But the sun here would sort of never pull back this far and get on this side of those signs, the southern side of the signs. It doesn't do that. So anyway, hope you kind of enjoyed that little tour there of one of my trips to Australia. But this is really the most important graphic of this video right here, of the extent of the tropics. It doesn't go as far north as I implied in some of my drawings, or south for that matter. The sun's direct rays do cover some of Australia here, but by and large, just that central part of the Earth, quite small rather, which is sort of known as the tropics. And they're sort of associated with very lushness and nice weather because the sun is always somewhere overhead in this region right here.